Very good morning, everyone, and welcome to today's market commentary. So as thought earlier, this double top pattern gave us the first target and it hit the low of 10,417.8 yesterday. So now we can expect a small bounce back from here. Let us just recall, why did we give this target? So first, based on pivot points, it closed below this central pivot point. And then the next day, the same central pivot point acted as a very strong resistance there. Next, this was a double top pattern to us. So this was the first top. And this was the second top. Now our first target was the difference between the high of the first top and its neckline. So that came to around 150 points. So from 10,600, our target was somewhere around 100 points down, and we are still 17 points away from our first target. So we are sure that it is going to hit there, and then it might give a small bounce back. So that was the major reason why we said that. And at central pivot point, we also had this Bollinger band support. So once the price closed below central pivot point and as well as this Bollinger band, we were sure that it is going to give a channel expansion there. So, and that is what it gave us. Now finally, where our target should be, it should be somewhere around 10,395. Why? Because we have a very strong support there. So the low of this candle is 10,395, as well as the opening, as well as the low price is somewhere around 10,395 for this green marubozu. So that is the reason it can act as a strong support, and we can see a good pullback towards this level, and from there we can see a small bounce back also in Nifty. So will this be activated, the target of this second top? That we can only say when 10,395 gets broken. So for us, the next level of target should be 10,400. And if you want to be further bearish, you need to wait for the level of 10,395 to get broken. So when this double top pattern was formed, we also had this RSI bearish divergence, where this top and this top, we compared the highs of both these tops, and the second top was higher than the first top, whereas the respective tops, when we compared with the RSI, so the second top of RSI is less than the first top of RSI. So that was RSI bearish divergence. So now let's go to intraday time frame, first 1 hour, and see what is the position of Nifty there. First, enabling our pivot points. So this S1 of this week, it acted as a very strong support to Nifty. Now in the yesterday's session itself, we had a breakdown of this S1, and from there we could see a very good fall of 50 points. So fall below S1 of this week, that itself gave us a confirmation of breakdown. And from there, we could see a very good bearish rally in Nifty. Now it all started when Nifty started trading below central pivot point. So on Monday, so that is on 21st, Nifty opened below central pivot point. and that was very much near to the strongest resistance of 10,600. So there itself, we were very cautious that it might give a good close below this line. So below central pivot point and closing below the strong support of 10,600 gave us a very good confirmation of bearishness that was coming in Nifty. So that gave us an alert to take a short position in Nifty. And from there, we had got somewhere around 130 rupees of profit. So next, we should definitely wait for a price action that happens near the level of 10,395. Only that price level is going to give us a clue whether we should be on bull side or on bear side. So if it gives a good bullish candlestick pattern or bullish setup near 10,395, then we'll be on bullish side. And if at all, if it breaks this 10,395 level, then we'll be again on bearish side. So on early time frame, we did not see this RSI. So what is RSI saying there? So RSI is showing a very pure bullish divergence. So now our immediate responsibility would be to draw a trend line resistance and wait for that to get broken. So first, let me draw this RSI bullish divergence. So from this low, I'm connecting this low. Let me just project it towards the right. So price is making lower low and RSI is making higher low. So bullish divergence on early time frame. So it is indicating bullishness. Now let me remove this double top pattern here. Now what we should do is we need to draw one horizontal resistance here and a trend line resistance. So at present, this is the only trend line resistance visible to us, connecting the high of this candle as well as high. So let me zoom it. So this is a trend line resistance. Now next, we need to mark a horizontal resistance. So this should act as a very strong resistance. Why? Because this candle is a very pure bearish Marabozu. Open is equal to high and close is equal to low. Very much near 419 and 421. So once the high of this candle is taken out, then a very good bullishness can be expected in Nifty, because on one side it is showing bullish divergence. On the other side, if it closes above the strong resistance of 10,478, then a very good bullishness can be seen. So what you need to do is wait until this 10,478 gets broken. To be precise, put it as 10,480. So after 10,480, again this trend line might act as a short-term resistance. So you'll be in bullish position already. You might have taken it at 10,480, but at this trend line resistance, if you find any bearishness coming in, like a bearish candlestick pattern, then you need to get out of the trade. And or else what you can do is just if you take two lots of Nifty, just close one lot here at this trend line resistance, and once it gives a good close above this trend line resistance also, then you can trail your position. So your target should be 10,535. So above 10,480, we expect Nifty to go until 10,535. But for this bullish divergence to be confirmed, Nifty needs to give a good close above 10,480. So that is the conclusion on early time frame. this is 15 minute time frame and we are enabling our pivot points. So Nifty gave a good close below the central pivot point already and it is coming down. So at this low of yesterday, it is taking a very good support. Now from here, if it forms a good bullish candlestick pattern, or if this green candle closes above this, then we can expect strong bullishness coming in Nifty. But on positional side, if you want to be on bullish side, wait until Nifty closes above 10,480. So once it closes above 10,480, if you can see, R1 of intraday and this trend line resistance are coinciding at this point. So this should be a very crucial level. 480, then 500, and then 530 should be your target. So this can happen in intraday itself today. So keep a very close eye, and today is also expiry of weekly Bank Nifty options. So that should also give a push. Either lesser volatility or higher volatility can be expected. And if at all there is a higher volatility, then Nifty can be seen approaching towards 10,500 at least. Now we have a strong resistance, 20 SMA at 10,480. So this is also giving us a second confirmation here. If 10,480 is taken out, we can expect a very strong bullishness in Nifty. Now we shall go to our other index, which is Bank Nifty. So it is taking support near the prior resistance. So this line we drew in our earlier market commentary. So at this line itself, it is now taking a very strong support. Yesterday it tried to give a close below that, but it was not able to sustain. So today price opened gap up, but even this bullishness is also not sustained. So pivot points, it is trading above central pivot point and below R1. So on daily, it is not giving us any hint. But this Bollinger band is indicating bearishness because price is trading below this 20 SMA. So that is a strong bearishness as far as Bank Nifty is concerned. But it needs to give a good close and sustain below this support, which is 25,700. If it gives a good close below 25,700 and if it sustains there, then immediately we can expect Bank Nifty reaching 25,460. So why 25,460? The low of this candle is 25,460 and the low of this candle is also somewhere around 25,460. So let us mark a line there. So if Bank Nifty sustains below 25,700, then we can expect further 270 points of fall, 230 points of fall. And on lower time frame, what is Bank Nifty telling us? Same, below 25,700. It already gave a good close on early time frame, but now this same 25,700 should act as resistance for two or three candles. So if 25,700 acts as resistance for two or more candles, then definitely you can enter at that point, keeping high of those candles as your stop loss and keeping 25,470 as your next target. So this is the range which we were talking about. Here Bank Nifty is taking a support, and if it gives a good close below that, then the range here, which is 25,460, should be your next target. Now let's enable our pivot points here on early time frame. So we have a very long range between P and S1, that is central pivot point and S1. But the good point here is that S1 is exactly at 25,486. So a very short range in between this. So then definitely this should act as a level. This should try to pull Bank Nifty towards itself, and this should act as a very strong support. So conclusion on Bank Nifty would be wait until 25700 is taken off again on daily time frame, and then you can enter there, keeping 25470 as your next target. Even here we should get a channel expansion because price is trading still under this 20 period moving average. Already this candle gave a good close below that. Now the same 20 period moving average is acting as a strong resistance there. So if it continues to act as strong resistance, and if it gives a good close below this 25700 on daily time frame, then things will act in favor of bearishness. But the main point to look out here is the bullish divergence that we can see in both the indices. So on hourly time frame, Nifty and Bank Nifty both are giving bullish divergence. So that is a point of concern here. If the prior resistance is taken out, then definitely a very good bullishness can be seen. And since both the indices are moving in the same direction, so you should not go against the trend here. So since we are observing this bullish divergence, we need to draw a resistance here, or at least we need to consider the pivot point. Since we don't have any pivot point, let us see. Let us consider this 20 period moving average. So if Bank Nifty closes above 25775, then this bullish divergence will get activated, and then we can see a rally until 25854 on first hand. And even if this is also taken out, 25900 is the next level. After that, 25967. So I'm repeating it again. If Bank Nifty closes above this 20 period moving average, that is 25775, then this bullish divergence gets activated. And once that gets activated, 25854 will be the first level or first target, 25900 will be the second target, and 25957 will be the final target for Bank Nifty. And on 15 minute time frame, let's enable the pivot points. So price is currently at central pivot point. So it is now entering the bullish zone. Bank Nifty is entering bullish zone here. So once today's high is taken out, then a very strong bullishness can be seen in Bank Nifty until 25854. Current price is 25750, and we can expect 100 point rally in Bank Nifty if it closes above today's high on 15 minute time frame. So that level is around 25760. Today's high is 25760. So if today's high is taken out, because on hourly time frame we have a bullish divergence, and on 15 minute time frame the immediate resistance for Bank Nifty is 25760. So if that is taken out, we can easily see a 100 point rally in Bank Nifty, that is until 25854. And above that we have 25900, and above that we have 25950. So these are the conclusions on Nifty and Bank Nifty. Although on higher time frames we are able to see bearishness, on lower time frame, like on hourly time frame, it is giving a slight bullish signals, like it is showing bullish divergences, and in further lower time frames it is crossing the immediate resistances. Now let's see some of the stocks for today. So first is Ambuja Cements. Ambuja Cements is approaching the strong support, trend line support here. Let me show you that. So from this low, I connected the low of this candle and projected it towards right. So this trend line support, whenever it is taken out, so that can give a very strong bearish movement in Ambuja Cements. Not only that, on weekly time frame we have a head and shoulders pattern in Ambuja Cements, and on daily time frame, if this trend line support, and if you can see, if I connect both the lows of this candle as well as today's low, then that is also a strong bearish signal. So if this support is taken out and if trend line support is also taken out, then that should give a very good bearish momentum, and the head and shoulders pattern on weekly time frame is already activated. So this is the neckline. And it already closed below that. So this is the first shoulder, this is the head, and this is the second shoulder. So it already closed below the neckline. And if you want to enter the rally now, then it is better to wait until this trend line support is taken out. So we have one stock from Nirav, which is HUL. So this ascending triangle already gave a very good rally to us, 1514 to 1620. So that is around 100 point rally. Now what we can do in Hindustan. So let us connect the highs and then project it towards right and see if we have any trend line resistance or support. So this high connected with this high and projecting it towards the right. So prior trend line resistance should now act as a support, but since this support is now taken out and a very good support was there at 1560 also, now that is also taken out, and this is happening in today's intraday time frame. So if this happens, if there is a good close below this, then we can expect Hindustan Unilever to come down until 1508. Now let us take the help of indicators, pivot point. So at R1 it tried to close above that, but it could not sustain and came below that. Now we don't have any pivot point supports also in between, and then Bollinger Bands. So only Bollinger Bands might give a support at 1518, and our final target is 1508 here in Hindustan Lever. But on 60 minute time frame, I think we can observe a head and shoulders pattern. Yes, a very pure head and shoulders pattern here. So this is the left shoulder, this is the head, and this is the right shoulder. So first 1 hour candle, it gave a good close below that. Now based on our height of this shoulder or height of this head, you can book your targets. So your first target should be from the neckline to the height of this right shoulder. So neckline is around 1560 and the right shoulder top is around 1585. So that is around 25 rupees. So from this neckline, you should be targeting 25 rupees towards the downside. And then again, you can trail your profits until the height of this head is reached. Now let us determine the height between the neckline and head. So head is around 1620 and this is 1560, so that is around 60 points. And towards the downside also we have a support near 1508 and the target also becomes the same. So conclusion on Hindustan Unilever would be, you can be bearish on Hindustan Unilever because on early time frame we have a perfect head and shoulders pattern that is happening at the top, and we have a good close. The first candle closed below the neckline. Now the same neckline is acting as resistance, which is 1560. So at this point you can enter keeping 1 or 2 rupees above the neckline as your stop loss, and you can put your first target, which is 25 rupees from 1560, so that is around 1535. And then if that is met, you can sell half of your shares or one lot out of the two lots that you are buying, and the next lot you can trail until 1508 is reached. So the next stock is Idea. So on daily, a small pullback is seen. We need to see if that is a good bullish divergence or not. So no sign of bullish divergence here. So is there any trend line resistance? Not a pure one. So we need to wait until this level is taken out. We have a red Marubozu here. So until that high is not taken out, we cannot be on bullish side. And we have this 20 period SMA also at the same price. So that comes to around 58.7. So wait until 59 is reached for Idea. And once 59 is reached, you can be on bullish side. So your next target should be 66.85. Do we have any supports or resistances? Yes. So here this level acted as a support, very good support. And once this is taken out and when price comes back again to the same price level, so that should now act as a strong resistance. So once Idea gives a good close above 59, you can aim for 66. So that's it for today's market commentary. Thank you all for joining.